In the previous video, we've seen that by doping a piece of silicon with either phosphorus or boron, we're able to change the number of electrons in the conduction band or to change the number of holes in the valence band. This allows us to engineer the conductivity of silicon very precisely. We've also learned that when visible light is absorbed by a piece of silicon, that an electron in the valence band can be promoted into the conduction band. Now, let's briefly talk about how a solar cell can be designed. I'll show you what happens when we bring together a piece of N-type silicon with a piece of P-type silicon. So imagine that down here, we've got a piece of silicon material that's been doped with some phosphorus. And up here, we've got some silicon that's been doped with some boron. And what I've drawn here are only the mobile charge carriers. Silicon has a lot of electrons that are just locked into the crystal where the bonds haven't been broken. Those don't make any difference because they can't move. They can't participate in electrical conduction. So what I'm trying to illustrate down here are the mobile electrons, the electrons in the conduction band donated to the lattice by the phosphorus. And what I'm illustrating up here are the holes in the valence band that are free to move around the crystal. Obviously, there are a few free electrons up here and a few free holes down here too, but the numbers are vanishingly small, so I've not drawn any of them. Once you start doping things with phosphorus or boron, the number of carriers due to the phosphorus or boron just completely and totally outnumber those that are intrinsic to the silicon itself. Now, in this situation here, I'm showing the mobile charge carriers. What do you think is going to happen with all of these holes up here and all of these electrons down here since they're mobile? Well, they're going to diffuse around the crystal, just like gas spreading out in a room. Now, it's worth pointing out that the situation shown here is electrically neutral. Although I've only drawn the mobile holes up here, the fact doesn't mean that the boron-doped silicon is somehow overall positively charged. No, every boron atom is electrically neutral. Every silicon atom is electrically neutral. Every phosphorus atom is electrically neutral. It's just that the holes are free to roam around the lattice. The same thing with the phosphorus-doped silicon. Overall, it's electrically neutral. It's not overall negative down here. It's just that the electrons in the conduction band happen to be free to move around the crystal. They're going to diffuse. And you'll start ending up with an excess number of electrons and holes on either side of the junction. So for example, if some of the electrons from the N-type material diffuse over here, some of the holes from the P-type material diffuse down here, what stops them from diffusing all over the place? Well, as the electrons diffused across the junction, it causes the P-type side to become just a little bit negative because now it has an excess number of electrons. Down here, we've gotten some holes that have diffused across the boundary because they're mobile. It's caused the N-type side to become slightly positively charged. So once the P-type side becomes slightly negative, it starts to repel more of the diffusion. Similarly, when the N-type side becomes slightly positive due to the holes which have diffused across the junction, it starts repelling additional holes that might like to diffuse across the junction too. So this process is kind of self-limiting, right? You don't get endless diffusion because a small amount of diffusion generates an internal electric field that will then oppose additional diffusion. Now, here's what's very special about this junction. I'm now not showing any of the internal charges, but we already know that they've rearranged themselves a little bit. But overall, the piece of silicon is still electrically neutral. If we were to measure the voltage across the piece of silicon, the voltmeter would read 0 volts. Two pieces of doped silicon brought together do not magically create a power source. The only thing that we have here is a slight internal charge redistribution. That's all. Near the junction, the P-type side is slightly negatively charged, and the N-type side is slightly positively charged. But that's only the case near the junction. There's no electric field that can be measured externally with a voltmeter. But what's really special is if light is absorbed by the silicon. Imagine now that a photon of light enters the block of silicon and excites one of the valence electrons up into the conduction band. This now has absolutely nothing to do with the boron or phosphorus, not just yet. It's just that by absorbing a photon of light, an electron, which was previously locked into the valence band and unable to move around, is now in the conduction band. It's free to move. And the hole it left behind is also free to move. Where's that hole going to go? And where's that electron going to go? Well, the hole will be attracted upwards to the p-type side because of the slight negative charge. And the electron will be attracted down here towards the n-type side because of the internal positive charge. If a lot of light is shining on a solar cell, we would then end up with a situation where huge numbers of holes bunch up at the p-type side of a solar cell, and huge numbers of electrons bunch up at the n-type side of the cell. This shows up as a voltage. It can be measured with a voltmeter. And that's how a solar cell works. It's really as simple as that. And if you put this into a circuit, then you can drive electrons around an external circuit and do useful electrical work. This business of putting together p-type and n-type materials is used to make transistors, integrated circuits, and it's really amazing to me that something as simple as conductivity engineering is responsible for changing the world and changing our lives so much. I hope that in this course you've come to appreciate semiconductors and now understand something about them.